Hey guys, XBadgerKnightX here, and this is Dota 2. This is probably one of the best games I've ever played as Sven. He's probably one of my most played heroes. He's pretty awesome. Once we get into the game, I'll kind of explain to you guys how he works and stuff, and why he's my favorite. But anyway, this game has the most insane Mexican standoff at the end. I won't spoil anything, you should just watch the video. It's super good. It's a super good game. And one thing you guys are probably noticing is that in certain parts of the video I get a lot of dropped FPS and frames, and I'm also recording this video in 720p as opposed to my normal 1080p at 60fps. I'm not sure if YouTube's gonna render this at 60fps, probably not, but yeah, it's gonna look kinda crap, but this is probably one of the best Dota games I've ever played ever, and I was playing on his account at the time because something was going on my PC and I needed to fix it. So we're just going through the picks here. I'm gonna provide my thoughts and commentary on what I was doing and what I thought my team needed to do and didn't do at certain points of the rest of the video. So I hope you enjoy it, and goodbye. Huskar is super scary. There's me. My name in game in this clip is Dunksin Slamo. As I said, it's my brother's account. So, one of the main problems that I have, because this is a calibrating game, it's ranked I'll pick. I was hovering around the 900 MMR bracket here. I think most of the people at the end of the game were like the 880 MMR bracket. I'm not sure. But, we'll see eventually. Dazzle was actually a great pick here before, for the build I'm going with as Sven, because we'll get to the build in just a second and I'll explain how it goes through the rest of the video. His shallow grave and the armor reduction and strength just makes Sven super awesome. It's just the constant heals, the slows, and shallow grave just make it really awesome. Yeah. So next pick's gonna be Spirit Breaker. Kind of annoying, can be kind of overzealous in this MMR bracket, with just diving people in towers and stuff like that. I do believe the next pick is going to be Phantom Assassin, if I'm not mistaken, in the middle there. Oh no, it's gonna be Slardar. We do have a Phantom Assassin. It's kind of weird that we picked Slardar, because I suppose it would actually make sense for Huskar, because he's probably gonna buy an Armlet, but the extra HP is probably what gives Armlet, you know, just so much strength. Brandon Brewmastering picked Klinks as the Phantom Assassin. Klinks and Templar Assassin are probably one of the more annoying things for us to deal with in this game. Oh, and fun fact, the Dazzle has no idea how to play Dazzle as well, so I have some experience with Dazzle, I tried to coach him and stuff, and here we are in the game. I skipped the part we were loading into it because it was just like 20 seconds of frame loss. So I'm going the standard TA5 build with Sven, but something a little different. Instead of buying something like, say, Mask of Madness or Attack Speed, because the Echo Saber's now in the game, I went with an Armlet, and this is basically the game that convinced me to go with Armlet, because Cleave, Echo Saber, Armlet, plus your ult just melts people. I think I do actually get some attack speed. I get the Soul Curious at the end of the game, but I'm not going to say too much about that. And I am, I was a little bit into the lane here, because I was still actually trying to figure out how to use the build menu and this resolution. And I actually wasn't recording this game, like playing this game at 720p, 1280 by 720p, or 720, I was actually recording it in 1200 by 600, so my mouse movements are to scale in that HUD, instead of normally like this. Probably gonna kill someone down here if, I'm not exactly sure what Slaughter is go first, but I know it wasn't a stun, because he probably would have tried something there.
The battle begins.
So the Huskar is gonna try and go on the Sardar. I'm telling him to bring him up here, so we might turn around and get a kill. But the Huskar is smart enough not to follow him, which is unfortunate. So the first thing that you do with this build for me is the build recommends tangos, a stout shield, a branch, and a mango, and I forget something else. What do you should go with? Mango, two mangoes for the stun when you're securing the bot rune or whatever rune you're securing. You throw it, you get the rune, try and get a kill, and you use the other one to follow up with whatever you have, whether it be a war cry or another stun in a couple seconds. Sven's stun is actually really powerful because it's an AoE stun. And I've landed stuns before that trap like three or four people and you just cleave them all to death and they die. And one of the main things that that was a problem for me when I played Sven a bit later with my friends is Diffusal Blade in this patch is so good now. So you put it on like someone like a, like say an anti-mage or a Phantom Lancer or a Juggernaut. And first blood, Omni-Knight. Thank you, come again. I'd probably get a killed Huskar if I was smart, but Burning Spear stack, I didn't want to risk it. I got my speed here. And this Slaughter for some reason buys Tranquils. I'm not sure if that's a thing or you should be buying Power Treads, but Slaughter's not exactly someone to just be like Crystal Maid and you mainly use spells, you smack people a bunch. I also realized I should have bought a Coiling Blade, but with the amount of stuff that I bought at the beginning of the game, didn't really think it was worth it. So I really wanted that Echo Saber and that extra attack speed. And what I usually do is I build the armor ring into a basilisk so I can get some help with Sven's horrendous mana problems at the beginning of the game without your treads. And also give a mana some to my allies and a bit of armor, you know. You know Warcry does that, but it helps still. And Huskar can get pretty scary when he's like half HP, especially with the Burning Spheres. I know he's considered bad, but no, at least in this patch. Like before, he was just like, "Please stop." Okay, there we go. I'm going in on him. All right, I think we killed the Huskar here. The Sardo does. All right, I think we may get the Omni-Knight here. Yeah, or I think he heals. I'm not sure. Yeah, and then the tower beats Slardar. Let's see if you're back in.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Radiant's courier has been.
For some reason, someone fed the courier. I'm not sure why. And you guys remember when I said this Dazzle has no idea how to play Dazzle? You'll see more of that coming up here in a couple minutes. Slaughter runs away even though this Omni-Knight has like no health. We kill him. I might die from tower shots, yeah. Yeah, can we kill the Huskar? Or no, Scripper can kill him. But we trade. Oh, it wasn't a bad trade. We killed Huskar and Omni-Knight, but Spiritbreaker got the kill, which can be a problem. And guys, just one thing if you're still kind of stuck in this MMR, just a couple tips. Always carry a TP scroll. Like seriously, I buy, like every time I die, I buy at least one or two to help with like pushes, rotations, stuff like that. Because you never know when Dead Phantom Assassin is routing your top tower while your entire team's trying to get a couple kills at bot or push something else. Also, stop calling your teammates idiots. It doesn't help anything. I may be doing bad, but just don't. I also need to get good at last hitting. It's hard with Cooling Blade Man, without a Cooling Blade Man. For worth.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
So usually when I'm like close to being 6 with Sven, I start trying to push down the towers a bit because my ult can do some serious damage. It's a double damage spell, so. Kill him. Yeah, I should run the wrong way because I'm an idiot. At least the Phantom Assassin lived. And her farm's important. She needs the Battle Fury, and then she can start building Desolator and crits. Or not, no, she doesn't build crits. She is the crit. She is the crit delivery system. Alright, so next item on the list is going to be an armlet, I think. Because I haven't actually had too many problems with mana this game so far. Because of how chill bottom lane has been, apart from us murdering everything, so. I'm gonna TP in bot here, trying to help slow the crystal lane a bit. I need to get to 6 so I can start pushing bot here, get some gold. We're gonna go in, cleave everything because Sven, and also we're gonna get 6, and then we're going to punch more things. Kill him. Very nice. Just as like a little pro tip for me, for Sven, well not like a pro tip, just like a strong suggestion. I always pop Warcry like right after the stun, no matter how long it is, because with how good like the armor is and stuff on Sven, like you have, I think, what is it, max level? I think you get like 20 something armor, like every 15 seconds, which is ridiculous. And with how much mana it costs and like late game, how much mana you get back from regen, it's super good. And that stacks with stuff like the armlet, which I plan on buying this game as well. I mean, heck man, I saw a Bloodseeker with an armlet once. That was very weird. They made armlet pretty good this patch. They improved it. And it's certainly not the best item, but I get too aggressive with things like the Mask of Madness, although the lifesteal is nice. And also the extra survivability and pocket HP kind of helped me. It's funny, I almost built my Sven like I built my Wraith King. And I actually, yeah, at this point I've kind of stopped going for Echo Saber. Actually, no, I don't go for Echo Saber because I need the extra damage for the armlet. And the cleave damage and the stuff like that is going to help me a lot. And if you stack that with the Echo Saber, it's seriously good. So I'm talking about with Sven's mana problems, you can't really throw that many stuns. There's also a Clixir, who... This is a very scary spot for me to be, so... I think I TP, yeah, I TP out here. I don't want to fight that. Not with that kind of mana. So I just need the, see the helmet, and I got my armlet. What most people like to do is, they like to go for the HP regeneration first, like the most expensive item first. I get, it's whatever helmet is in the bottom right corner, I don't remember the name. I think you get something like 4 HP a second, which is like, I think like half a tango. It's pretty good. But Sven attacks so slow in the early game when he has like the ability to do like decent damage, especially with like the ult and the stun and stuff. So I go for the extra attack speed, even though it's like the notice, it's like negligible. I go in here, pop the ult, start punching things, kill the Huskar, kill everything. Random assassin's blocking me, kill him. Okay. And that was that. That's why Sven's so cool. I think the cleave is probably one of the coolest things in the game. And, fun fact, Sven was actually the first Dota hero I ever played in Dota. It's probably why I'm decent with him. I'm not saying I'm good with him. There's times where it's just like derp. Sven is countered by heroes who have a lot of stuns and disables, like say, literally every hero in the game. So a BKB is almost core on him unless you have someone who has like a lot of counter initiations, stuns like that, things that can help you out, like such as Dazzle's Shallowgrave. And that's also where I think the armlet will come into play, because the extra pocket HP and armor really help out a lot. Bye, Phantom, sorry. I did what I could, man. Yeah, the biggest problem I have when doing this build with the armlet is, Sven's really crappy mana pool. Like, if I had treads right now, I could just mana switch, or just tread switch for more mana for the stun. I don't know why I didn't go in here with the armlet. Probably gonna gotta kill, my team's rotating. Just looking at the item builds here. Helmet of Dom, that's 10 on Huskar. I'm not sure what this Dazzle's been doing for most of the game, but he doesn't really have anything. Is he going for mana boots, man? I don't know. We'll find out. He's also getting punched down by the Huskar. I kill the Huskar, stun the Armlet, Warcry, punch, punch, punch. Punch, punch, punch. And he pops the ult. And I might die here. Yeah. The Phantom Assassin is still punching the Omni Knight, who is immune to physical damage. Here we kill the Omni Knight. I'm trying to get out of here. It's like non-stop action here, guys. Non-stop. He dies. Huskar gets an armlet. I need 450 gold for my treads. I should. Looking back at this game now, I probably should have farmed a bit more as Sven, because Sven is not the kind of guy who can just go into fights and just kill everyone like right off the bat. Like, he needs a lot of gold and experience. He needs levels, he needs stats, which is why some builds actually, like this one, forego maxing out the stun at the beginning, which I kind of disagree with, because that means more initiation damage, more, you know, like say you're chasing out like a Quince or something, and he goes in Viz. I mean, that kind of damage can be kind of kind of important when you're dealing with heroes like that, so. But then again, Sven's stats are kind of also important because of his low mana pool, which can be alleviated by buying treads or just specking in his stats a little bit. I'll buy iron branches at the beginning of the game, which is actually what this build recommends, but I don't.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
And experimenting more with this build, I found that a satanic, like building from Helm of the Dom, is actually pretty cool with the lifesteal and the armlet. Because 200%, you get some of the HP back from the armlet. You know, you survive a bit more longer. So again, looking back at this game, I should be in the jungle right now, hitting creeps, instead of just walking around doing nothing. What's cool about like watching the game back in Dota 2, like the replay viewer, is that you actually see like at what point the enemies got their items. Which is kind of cool in retrospect. So we know that Husker got like a sub 15 minute armlet, TA got a 15 minute desolator, which is, that's pretty good, and also terrifying and scary. I think right here I'm telling the Dazzle to go in and kill this Templar Assassin. Just Shallow Grave me, I'll just punch him a couple times. Or smack him with my giant freaking sword, because Sven. Oscar's gonna leap at me. Goodbye. Kill everything. I'm like, Oscar. He doesn't know how to Shallow Grave. I probably could have won that fight too. So here's where things started getting a bit more complicated. So the Huskar's pretty fair, the Templar Assassin's pretty fair. Omni-Knight's getting annoying with his ult. We don't really have much in the way of magical damage except for literally my cleave and Ember Spirit. So it's kind of hard to deal with Omni's ultimate.
Radiant's middle tower has fallen.
So we're trying to kill this Omni right here. Templar Assassin, like everyone's everywhere here. I'm gonna toggle here yet. Build a stun. Yo, he learns how to Shallow Grave, amazing! We're turning around, kind of, but the Templar Assassin still murders everyone. Alright, and then it's a team wipe, guys. Holy crap. For some reason, my team decides it's a good idea not to push. Except for purple. Phantom Assassin gets the idea. I'm like pinging everywhere, dude. We gotta push. They already got our tier twos at this moment, at this point in the game, which is very scary. So we're like, look at the map right now. We're very lucky in the objective game. We've just been going around trying to get kills and stuff, which obviously in Dota does not work like at all. So you gotta deal with that a little bit. Not just like a little bit. It's called Defense of the Ancients for a reason. Leap from Huskar. I did a turn around. With the clinks there? I'm trying to go in here. Well, the TA is marked from Sardar. Sardar, actually, I take that back from what I said in the beginning. It's a good pick in the situation because of the suicide thing. I think we actually do end up killing the top assassin here. I don't think he realized that Sardar's ult gives us a vision of where he is when he's invisible. So trying to kill the Somni out here is being a real annoyance. I mean, most of the team is dead, we should be getting the tower and not going for kills, but some people just don't realize that. About halfway done with the Echo Saber as well. Well, actually, mostly halfway done with the Echo Saber, because just disassemble the Bassy, and get the Quarterstaff, get the Ogre Club, and you're good. This guy's gonna leap me, I die. And for some reason, everyone decides to go in. They're not sure though. So, any team's pushing mid, we have like literally, we have like one tower that's outside the base alive right now. So, we're in some trouble. Dazzle's only level 9. I mean, like, they literally have us surrounded from all sides here. I can't really go in without my team. Who, again, they need to learn how to carry two scrolls. Look at this Huskar! I just noticed that, he's like, nope! And Dazzle doesn't shallow grave me again. Just the size of our cliff people. We're probably gonna have some decent damage there. And they're going in again. I don't understand. Dazzle still doesn't. Okay, he shallow graves a Slardar. Okay, we turned that around, but that was pretty messy though. Tay manages to team wipe us with the Dazzle. She's getting pretty scary with that Desolator. Link's assassin trouble with the tower, yeah. So I'm back. I need to stop this push. Because we literally cannot lose this tower at this point. We go in, make a runaway bit. Ember Spirit follows up. She's invisible. So I think I actually kill her with a cleave, yeah. I kill her right here with a cleave. I see you. Yeah, I do. So, So, Clink's just brought in an item called Orchid Malevolence, which basically it's the main reason why people buy it now is so you can get Bloodthorn, which is a ridiculous item in my opinion. It's like, I think the second most expensive item in the game next to like Dagon 5 or something, or Dagon 6. I don't know if it even goes that high, but basically what happens, you click on someone, you use the item on an enemy, it silences them, and any damage done to it will be done in the way of crits, so 1.5 crits, and it's all reliable. So you can't not get crits while the thing is up, which is I think super broken and stupid, and I don't think it needs to be in the game, because it turns people like OD and Invoker into like something crazy. Invoker is a bad example. OD is probably a good example of Bloodthorn. Because there's literally, I don't think there's, I can't think of a way to counter it other than just to silence them, which is ironic considering that you have to silence the island, that the island itself basically silences your side. Or you have to disable them long enough with like stuns and that kind of thing for them like not to silence you and just right click them, which is kind of hard. But then again, it's a magical item, so stuff like BKBs, Lincoln Spears, stuff like that also counter it. He's got drums, I'm trying to throw the stun here, just not in range yet. So I have to go for this Omni Knight, which... yeah, that clings his Bloodthorn is a problem. Brian decides to shall aggrave me. Murder everyone until Omni pops his ult. And we don't actually have a single ranged hero, other than Dazzle, which is a kind of a problem. Because they got Huskar, they got Klinks, TA is going to be a bit of a problem here. Especially Klinks, because at this point in the game, he's just going to try and rat whichever Rax is going to be weakest. You know, just buy Boots of Travel, TP in on a wave of creeps or a friendly hero, and just go in. Alright, so we're back. Just respawn. And we kill everyone. Well, not quite yet. This is why Armlet is so awesome, right here. The damage. You can't stop it, man. You cannot. One thing I really need to learn how to do is how to like shut off my Armlet when I'm chasing someone. And this build right here, it gets super good with crits. Like, you have no idea. And Klinks goes invis right here. And I don't think Dazzle knows that wards are a thing either, which is, again, a problem. I mean, you saw earlier in the game, like, this is a problem, right? So, everyone is just so worried about, like, building their own items and stuff that we need to, like, just go ahead and, like, buy dust or whatever to try to kill Klinks, but we can't because we're all just so worried about our own items and builds. And Temple Assassin at this point gets crits, which is again kind of scary. And I also have crits of my own. I got a Crystallis. Let's talk about the Armlet a little bit again. So, 500 pocket HP when your HP is stuck at 1. You can toggle it. It gives you more damage, more armor. Like, alright, so we maxed out the 3. Sven's Warcry. I get 25 armor plus whatever base armor I have during that duration. And I think when Armlet's toggled, I get something like 30 in that range. So it makes me super tanky, and I think actually later I buy Assault Curious, just for the armor aura and the attack speed, which makes it super good. Also, I did not see that Klinks there, because he was kind of invisible. Also, in that situation, Armlet is super good because of the overheal. He probably would have killed me there. We go in, Venom Assassin blocks me, but I managed to pick up a couple kills here. I'm not actually sure how Armlet affects Sven's Cleave. Actually, it gives you more damage, right? And Sven's Cleave is like a percentage of whatever base damage you do. So, I mean, it's. I think it's just good for that reason. And this Armlet for some reason walks inside the base. I'm not exactly sure what he's doing. The Huskar is to punch him down. Huskar gets a leap. Got some tower shots in the starter. We got the clinks. Now for the Omni Knight. I think that's what she says to me at one point. Sven, I'm not your support anymore. Which... why? Supports aren't, like, technically... I'm not even gonna get into that. That's just stupid. That's just dumb. Why would you say that? Like, in the first place. I know this guy kind of is new to Dazzle, but... Role of supports, man. Support, you just don't... I mean, in this situation, it's wise to support me or the most fed person on the team. You can do a lot of damage. I can, like, nuke entire teams with the cleave and the armlet and Sven's ult. I can also survive more fights with the Warcry and the extra armlet I get, or the extra armor I get from the armlet and the Warcry. Also, Zazzle's shallow grave means I can just jump in the middle of a fight, do a lot of damage, kill a couple people and have my team finish them off. What I also see a lot of people do for Sven is they use him as a sort of pseudo pusher. Because the cleave, again, can nuke entire creep waves like this. So it can be super good. Like, some builds actually recommend Boots of Travel on him, which I would agree is a super good item. Like for late game, not for early game, because he needs the extra mana from the treads and stuff. And my team decides he's going to need to jump in level 5 dudes again, so this Huskar is going to die. Just no question about it. Dazzle Shallow Graves me, thank you. You go for him. Space Cow dies. We should probably push now. Guru. The double damage is also good for pushing lanes like this. Because you, like, if you have another damage item, like, again, armlet or something else. Oh, I actually got the Echo Saber, I didn't notice that. So, it's like, it's super good. But, this Tumble Assassin is going to be quite of a problem. But for some reason, he goes back and decides to kill, Dazzle. Instead of me. Which may, in fact, cost her the game. Also, I think there's also a Clink's chasing me, so... Yeah, I think there is. Yeah, there it is. Armlet toggle. Dire's bottom tower is under attack. Radiant structures are fortified. Looks pretty bleak now, huh? They got all the towers outside. I think they even got our top racks. I can't tell from the way I'm watching this this video. All the lanes are pushed. We got some of their towers, but they didn't play the objective hard enough. So at this point, I'm starting to build the Soul Cures. I usually buy the Hyper Zone first because of the extra attack speed again, so I'm gonna do this. It's so good, man. It's so good. You cleave, you can just nuke entire teams that are just standing together, which is it pairs so well with Sven's stun, it's not even funny. If you can manage to stun one or two more people, you're guaranteed like one kill. Or a lot of damage. There's no way I'm gonna get this on tonight with the buff that he has on, so. Actually, we keep chasing him. I'm trying to think like here. Yeah, I click on the top here. Yeah, there's Dazzle, and I just had to back up. I guess one of the side effects of all the lanes being pushed in this is I get unlimited farm, basically. Like, they come to me, just whack them a bunch. Yeah, okay, so we lost our, we're about to lose our top racks. We have no top or mid tower. Bot is still standing at the moment. But I think in a couple minutes this, the Clinch is going to come in and try and rat it. Alright, so here we got the Assault Curious. Attack speed, armor, aura, very good item. You mostly get it for the attack speed because, damage, Sven. Good, we've been over this a couple times. It's gone. Dazzle has regressed so far that Slardar is buying the wards. Yeah, I think we thought we were going for Roche. So, we just have to defend here for 5 minutes until the Aegis expires or we kill Huskar. Which at this point you've seen me do. Like for the entire team, if I can just pick a target, whack him a couple times, get some support from Dazzle, Ember Spirit, some Slardar with the armor disable, and Dazzle's ult, which I think he only uses like a handful of times here. So I really want to go in here. Yeah, there we go. We killed Dazzle, we killed Huskar. Also PKB again. Kill Huskar again. I'm trying to throw the stun, but I'm being slowed by Huskar's switch things. Not sure what this double assassin's doing, but she's dead. We decided to back up, because Klinks is still alive, and if Shelly Grave by Dazzle. But if we try to push now, I think I was afraid that Klinks or Spirit Breaker would just charge bot and just take the rack, so we decided to defend. And I think at this point, I was considering either buying a Divine Rapier or Boots of Travel, just in case, because we could totally win a team fight on our turf, definitely. If I can believe hard enough, man. I don't think Sara knew that was an illusion. So this, the illusion is trying to rat us, guys. This, the strats. So it's the Klinks. It also makes me waste my stun, and I don't even know why I go for him, or didn't go for him rather. So at this point, we're just talking strats. I'm just trying to get enough gold and farm to buy whatever else I need. I definitely need a Daedalus. I mean, at this point, we were thinking that we can't really do anything until Clinx is dead, so. So dead for a while. Sarda decides it's a good reason to jump in the middle of five dudes and die for no reason, but this is America, he'll do what he wants. Suicide by gang squad. I mean, yeah, I could go in here, definitely. So, take it, kill the space cow a couple times. Hello, my team's out here. Dazzle Shallow Graves me, but wasn't enough. I need the whole team here. Throw the stun, war cry, kill him, or try to. Most of the team got wiped in that fight. And I think in this fight we actually lose our mid barracks. So what's going on in this? I mean, still though, we can't kill him without sentries and. Dazzle, we don't have dust, we don't have sentries, man. I mean, I'm too busy trying to buy items so I can carry the rest of the game, but I mean, I sound like a hypocrite because of the stuff I said before, right? But still though, it's important, especially at this point in the game. We need some rat power. Phantom Assassin, I can rat. So can Ember Spirit, because you can put down the little things for it. I've never played Ember Spirit, whatever they are. Things you can teleport to. But, yeah. Threadbreaker. This is the play right here. This is my favorite thing I've ever done in Dota. Cleave everything and win! And their whole team is dead except for Clinx. I'm too good to die from this. So I guess me and Ember Spirit decide it's a good idea to push. Most of the team's dead. I think Phantom Assassin's with me. And there's the Bloodthorn, guys. That's why it is the most. Actually, no, he doesn't have a Bloodthorn. My bad. He just has crits, man. I don't think Echo Saber should be something that range heal should have, because I don't know, on people like Clinx and Drow, it's just like so good. I think it just should be just like a melee hero thing. That's just me, because you saw how much how fast he nuked me. Now imagine that plus Bloodthorn, and this guy already has crits, which begs the question: why doesn't he disassemble it and turn into a Bloodthorn? I don't know. He already has a Crystallis in his inventory, but Pia's right in mid, which is good because once the team is dead, there's also a courier there, and Rush is gonna be back in a couple seconds, so there's also that. Well, I don't know what he's doing. He decides to go try and kill the hero that can invis, which does not work at all. At this point, I'm actually considering a Divine Rapier. Because, I already do a lot of damage, but I need to do enough damage to nuke the team. That was my logic, but, yeah, I just eventually decided to go for it because of how many times I just dove into team fights and my team wasn't there to help me or just died because of stupid reasons. So I decided to just take this tower. Nuke it a bit. Wait for the TP boost to come back. Thing I'm just try and keep pushing here, unless this Clinks wants to get me. I'm being charged as well, so. Nothing I can really do about that. Here he comes, and charge. Oh, like, Clinks already fires fast already. I mean, maybe the Echo Saber was a waste on him, but, you know, it's like, anyone else familiar with, like, how the AI-94 worked in Battlefield 4, where, due to, like, how the servers worked and whatever, you would effectively be firing, two bullets at once, or, like four bullets effectively at once because of, like how fast the fire rate was going. I think it was like theoretically, like if we were to get like the perfect spread for it, the perfect burst for it, it would be like 1200 rounds a minute, which is kind of crazy. But at the same time, you know, like how the servers were working, effectively shooting four bullets at a time. That's what I think about like heroes like Drow or Clinks, sometimes OD, yeah, with the Echo Saber. It's like that, like, it's super good, but kind of wasteful and bullshit, honestly. So, I actually have never used Boots of Travel on any hero before this game, so this is all new to me. Like, I didn't know that the upgraded versions actually teleported you to friendly heroes instead of creeps. I mean, really, the only problem here is Clinks. Like, he has a Bloodthorn. You can nuke us with the Echo Saber. I was actually in the process of building a BKB. Like, after I was done building the Data List, because I mean, I don't know, man. Clutch Crit could come in handy, like right here. I mean, I already do enough damage, but you know. I think it probably would have been wise to just build the BKB instead. I cancel TP like a boss because I'm about that life. So now the buyback war starts. And they have on board, they have money for him, huh? So Clinks is actually dead. We can actually make some space here. We're just pushing up bot. Thriftbreaker is charging Ember Spirit though. Yeah, I should probably be coming in right now. And there's the ALT. So it kind of stops the PS push. Also kills most of our team, she's probably gonna die as well. The slaughter's gonna win though. That's why Boots of Traveler is so good, my friends. Kill him. Look at that. There we go. That's what I'm talking about. That's why I love Sven. The cleaves, man. So good. And I died of creeps because I'm a boss. I'm max level right now. I got get the recipe for my Daedalus and the I think the second the upgrade of Blitz Travel. So that's all good. So most of our team, most of the teams on both sides are dead. Spirit Breaker can, however, charge PA at top, which I think he's doing right now. So. Yeah, she's probably gonna die. I think we okay, so both of us piece of bot. Okay, so I got the second phase of us to travel. And I don't know if you guys noticed this before, but forgot to mention all of our towers are gone, even the racks. So even the slightest bit of push is risky because of the risk of just Omega creeps just coming in and just destroying everything. We still have the two towers in the middle though, by the ancient, but it's still kind of hard to defend. Rush is back, so I think we might actually go for him. Alright, so they actually get Roche here. They give it to Templar Assassin. I would have given it to Huskar or Spiritbreaker again, or even Klinks. If they give it to Klinks, that'd probably been the game, I think. Just because of how. How rats are crap out of us. It's a scary item set. So Klinks now has Bloodthorn, and Sarda just got his Silver Edge. So think about that for a second. Silenced. 1.5 amp crit damage from any person that attacks it. Attacks the orchided victim. Kinda crazy. So yeah. So I think at this point I try to tell my team that there's literally no way else we can win. They can't fight me one on one in team fights without me and Dazzle's help. So I figured we have to wait for them to try and take the racks, and then we bat them off. We try to fight them and see how that goes. So I killed the Omni Knight. He's dead. Ult for no reason. The damage, man, it's crazy. We can't stop it.
Okay.
So we have to buy over 100 seconds worth of time, I think, if I'm reading that correctly. The problem is they're not dead for long enough to us for just to push up mid and win. Like with crits and everything. I mean, we could probably end the game now, but then look what's happened down at bot, guys. They're just wrecking the racks, man. Go in, slap some people. Dazzle ults. They can't stop me right now. They just deal too much damage. And super tanky too. If I'm reading that right, I have 45 armor right now. And without Warcry. Well, that was 45 armor, like with Warcry on, I think. 61? I don't know, man. I can't read on this resolution. And again, as I was talking about earlier, so we have no racks, no towers besides I think the one left standing in mid. So really the only option we have here. Oh, okay, we still have bot racks, so the game's still kind of winnable. I could farm and farm and farm until I get to a certain point. I mean, at this point I really have all my items, right? There's some things I could switch out, but I think it would be fine either way. But the thing is, with the boots of travel, we need to push out far enough, and I'm wasting my ult here because my mouse, the mouse drivers on my brother's laptop weren't set up correctly, like the binds I use for him. I play Dota almost entirely on the mouse, except for the WASD keys to move the keyboard, the camera and stuff. And what happens when I play heroes with more than 4 abilities? I don't. Just kidding. I guess 5 and 6. And, okay, yeah, at this point, I'm like, we should probably get a Divine Rapier. But Dazzle kind of persuades me out of it, and I kind of thank him for that, even though he is kind of stupid. Yeah, that's actually, I didn't actually notice that, Scriber, Soul Kira. Sounded like it matters anyway, dude. They're getting melted to pieces. So good. Just keep mashing away at them until they die. And most of our team is dead. And Dazzle, for some reason, shall I grab Spirit Breaker. Or, not Spirit Breaker, Sardar. Sorry. You guys know the point, guys. We can't really do anything. We can't push. Creeps are coming in. Like, we have to defend the base from the enemy team, and then their creeps. It's hard. I mean, kind of the reason why I consider getting a Divine Rapier is because we have literally nothing to lose while put the game, but I mean, they have like most of our racks. We have one tower. I figured if we get it, just get one solid push up, and then we're good. Just nuke the whole team with the rapier, do some double damage. Then we go in, and then the entire team dies here, and then I get a big KB. I actually didn't notice this until later, and I think we're coming to the end of the video here. So swap the treads for the boots of travel. And they were dead for some while, dude. So I just noticed this, I'm like, oh shit, they're dead. We should probably be pushing right now. Huskar comes back though, and the Omni Knight. I'm not actually sure if we push now or later, but we do push. TA is out for another minute, I think, judging from the scrawny text here. Spirit Breaker's out for another like 10 or so seconds. Clanks and TA are probably the biggest problems right now. Maybe with Omni Knight's ulti, just minor annoyances.
Dota's bottom tower is under attack.
You notice bot's getting wrecked here. Like, the dilemma here, guys, it's like... Actually, I didn't actually draw Slaughter, I got a Divine Rapier. I did not notice that. Like, at all. I did not know that. So TP on Sardar, we go in. We're gonna try and take the bot racks, like right now. The whole TM's coming back, this is gonna be pretty risky. We can get the tower, but I'm not sure about anything else. BKB, punch everything, smack you, smack you, smack you. I buy back. Rosh is coming back. I buy back into the base. I put the BKB back in the shop, stash, because it's on cooldown and won't be using it for a while. TP back into the fight. And cancel it because we're getting wrecked up there, and I'm also the last guy, so if I die, we're all messed up. Game's over. Back.
Even death may die.
Again, so we still have to defend. I mean, I can't really do anything until our team's back, but you know, at the same time, enemy team's also kind of screwed. Oh, action bot going on here. Fill this time, let my team to escape. At the same time, we lose the bot racks. Pick the BKB from the shop. Go in, murder everything. If the Omni Knight pops dust for some reason. Also really slow. Go back to defend the base. Just get back to run the shit out of us. That was a big mistake, actually. Sorry, my son. Take the Crypt Aggro away from the Ancient. Dazzle calls GG. Gonna get some kills. So the only way we can actually win this is to just push mid. If we can. And look what we're doing now. I just realized their entire team was dead because of Slardar and just Divine Rapier. I did not notice that. Like in the game at the moment. But guess what we're doing, guys? We're going for the W. We're going for it. Whole team is dead. I don't think they have buyback. They wasted all their money. It's on cooldown. Beggar Crypts are pushing. We push harder. Whole team. Warcry, turn the armlet, smack the tower a bunch of times. I'm out damaging the backdoor protection, no creeps. So Slaughter with a Divine Rapier. Smack down a bunch of times, BKB. We can do this, we can totally do this. Tempo Assassin, not a problem. Omni Knight might be a problem if he ulted. And he does, he gets the ulti off. We have to buy a couple seconds of time. We fill the stun, I get over here. Slaughter is a distraction, whatever he is, slug. I punched the Ancient a couple times, and we got it. We won. What a game. Favorite game of Dota of all time, guys. What do you think? Make sure you guys leave a comment on what you thought about this video, and if I should do more of these things, kind of like a game analysis kind of thing, where I take a Dota game or a CSGO game, and I just go ahead and analyze it a little bit, go through my thought process of what's going on in the game, for like any game, rather. It doesn't have to be CSGO, Dota, could be like Insurgency, XCOM, Mass Effect, or literally whatever you want. If you want to see one of those, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe for more. And let me know how I did with the video and everything in the form of a comment or a like. And this has been XBadgerKnightX, and I'll see you guys later. Bye!